Takshila, Nalanda, Vikramshila, Valabhi, all of these, the centers of educational excellence of olden days. Now let's focus on these one by one. So first we focus on Nalanda. Nalanda was a seat of learning closer to present-day Patna, nearly 55 kilometers southeast of present-day Patna in Bihar. Now this center was a center that was established during the Gupta period. It was a center for Buddhist learning and Buddhist excellence, and Sakratitya was one during whose time Nalanda started to grow and achieved its peak. During the invasions, it was believed that the library of Nalanda was severely destroyed and nearly 9 million manuscripts were vanished off in fire, and a lot of literature, a lot of works that was compiled during that time related to grammar, logic, literature were affected. You had Nalanda, which was the seat for international students coming from China, Persia, Greece, and across the globe. Again, this was the place where during the reign of Harsha Empire in the Gupta period, most of the Nalanda universities, the Nalanda centers achieved their excellence. Aryabhatt, Nagarjuna are some of the most renowned names when it comes to Nalanda. Recently, in 2014, this Nalanda was restored and you had Nalanda International University that was established. Previously, only under the archaeological excavations of Alexander Kunming, you had the ruins of the Nalanda that were found. Again, one of the very important things that we need to understand whenever we are focusing on institutes of higher learning in India, each had its own parameter for assessment. It was believed that the security at the gate of Nalanda itself used to ask certain questions. If you were able to answer those questions, only then you were admitted to the Nalanda University, and that was the culture of higher education that was prevalent in India. Coming up onto some of the most important scholars from Nalanda, so you had Aryabhatt. Aryabhatt was born originally in Kerala, but later he moved to the region of Nalanda near Patna, and he was one of the greatest mathematicians. He also established a sun temple at Taragan near Patna in Bihar, and one of the most important findings that he laid down was approximate value for pi, which was considered 3.1. Now, the next important was Nagarjuna. He was one of the greatest Buddhist philosophers and was known to spread the Mahayana Buddhism. So Buddhism was later divided into Mahayana and Hinayana, and he was one of the propounders of the Madhyamika school, which was the Mahayana Buddhism. His numerous works have been attributed. Some of his works include Exposition of an Awakening Mind, The Letter to a Good Friend, talking about the end of disputes, and each of those had their own names that were there. Bhavasim Kranti was one of the commentaries that were written, and a lot of literature was written by Nagarjuna. The next important university that we would focus on is Takshila. Now, Takshila lies in the present-day Pakistan in the Punjab province. It was one of the major seats for Vedic learning, and here was where you had Chanakya or Kautilya that was part of this university. Again, in Takshila, you had the Mahayana sect of Buddhism that gained its importance, and this Takshila is considered one of the oldest universities, which was a link between the South Asia as well as the Central Asia. So, scholars coming from Central Asia as well as South Asia in the regions of Takshila. The first major Takshila settlement was established nearly around 1000 BC, and that was the time frame where you had a lot of historical sanctity that was seen among Buddhism and Hinduism. A lot of teachings of Buddhism was adopted as a part of curriculum in Takshila, and here was where you had instructions that were given across various disciplines, be it archery, be it archaeology, be it astronomy. So you had Chanakya as one of the major philosophers, and Chanakya was the one who was the royal advisor of Chandragupta Maurya, or who basically trained Chandragupta Maurya, who ultimately developed the Mauryan Empire and founded the Mauryan Empire, laid down the foundations of Mauryan Empire in India. So Kautilya was born in Andhra Pradesh, in the Gola area of Andhra Pradesh, and he took his last breath at Pataliputra. So his whole journey was across the subcontinent, starting from Andhra Pradesh to Takshila and then to Pataliputra. He was also known as Kautilya or Vishnugupta. He was one of the leaders known for his vision for political science as well as economics, and his work, which was known as Arthashastra, is one of its own kind, where you had formulations of economic policies along with military strategies, and this whole Arthashastra was written in Sanskrit. During the various empires, mainly you had the Mauryan Empire that was there. Later on, you had Kushans. Later, you had the Indo-Greeks. And finally, the Gupta. All of these witnessed the developments in Takshila. So, during the Kushan ruler, Shrikush, you had one of the ancient settlements that was brought about, and that was the town of Takshila, closer to the Takshila University. And a lot of diplomatic contacts were built between India, Indian subcontinent, and the Persian region. Later on, when you had Indo-Greeks that were there, you have Sirkap, which was one of the new capitals that was built opposite to the Takshila. So opposite side of the Takshila was Sirkap that was built up. The next university that we would focus on is Vikramshila. Now, Vikramshila is one of the major centers of learning during Pala Empire, and this is in the present day regions of Bhagalpur. So, Bhagalpur in Bihar is the area where you had the ruins of Vikramshila University that was seen. It was during the reign of Dharmapal that Vikramshila started to grow, and you had numerous subjects related to philosophy, metaphysics, grammar, Indian logic that were taught at Vikramshila. Some of the various scholars that were present, except Sridhar, are the following scholars. So, Leela Vajra is another important scholar that is very, very important for you to know. And among all these, as we said, Sridhar was one of the major prominent figures of Vikramshila University. Now, talking about Sridhar, he was also known as Sridhar Acharya. He was one of the India's greatest mathematician, Sanskrit scholar, as well as a philosopher. He was born in a village in South Radhe, the present day Hooghly area, and he did whole of the calculations with zero. So addition with zero gives you the same number, subtraction with zero gives you the same number, product with zero gives you zero. What the kind of experiments that he laid down. He also differentiated algebra from arithmetic and gave the formulations to solve the quadratic equations during that time. So again, a very great mathematician, Sridhar Acharya. The next university that we would focus on is Valabhi. Now, Valabhi was again a Buddhist center for learning in the regions of Saurashtra and Gujarat. This was again important because it was a region where you had a lot of international trade, mainly from the Bhavnagar region. Theology, Niti, which is the political science, statesmanship, business, administration, law, agriculture, were some of the subjects that were popularly taught at Valabhi. So Valabhi is another important university that we focus on. So those were some of the major ancient universities in India. Now, this has over the years gained a lot of momentum, a lot of studies being conducted on the ancient literature, the ancient universities. We would be coming up with series of many such important topics for you. Stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.